Smith. Here with another of our true and exciting stories from the Big Story newsstand. These are stories of conflict and stories of crisis, and all of them filled in with bits and pieces of people's lives. Now tonight, the conflict is sharp, bitter, clearly defined. The people, a mother and a son, the crisis, the boy's desperate attempt to uncover a secret. The secret of becoming a man too fast and too soon. And in the middle, the reporter who put it all together and made a never-to-be-forgotten big story. From the pages of this newspaper, the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. It happened here in Fort Worth, Texas. Still a cattle town. Largest meat packer south of Kansas City, a modern metropolis, but still close to the frontier of the old Southwest, where gunplay and hard-riding men had long been part of the landscape, where men still shoot fast and with deadly accuracy. The story started here on Highway 199, a daring robbery, a vicious beating. By nightfall, six more in the same area. He was armed, desperate, hiding somewhere in these woods. From among the hunters and the hunted, someone would have to die. The ending seemed inevitable until reporter Tony Slaughter supplied a brand new ending and saved a man's life. It's his big story from the front pages of the Fort Worth Star-Telegram. House lived a youth named Roy Parker. He was 18 years old. Not quite a boy, not quite a man. This was Roy's mother, 2 years a widow. That's very important to this story. Very important.
Oh, thank you, Mary. No, look, I can put it on.
The wind coming up.
Well, I've been laying in some wood up at the farm.
It's going to be an early winter.
Say it's going to be a cold one.
But a good one.
You know, Mary, I was kind of worried about today.
I know, Howard.
Your husband was a fine man.
Yes.
I didn't know if you wanted to get married again.
I didn't think I would.
But you accepted me.
I found another fine man.
Well, you'll never be sorry. I promise you.
Roy?
Well, hello, Roy.
Mr. Sutton's talking to you, son.
I'm glad you came over, Roy. Your mother and I've got something to tell you.
Howard, let me be alone.
Yep, but I'd like to be here, Mary.
It's for me to do.
I'll be back tonight. We'll be seeing a lot of each other, Roy.
I'll talk to him.
Bye.
Bye. Roy? You weren't very polite to Mr. Sutton, Roy. Roy?
You gave him pause, Jack.
How long were you standing there?
Long enough.
I have no secrets from you.
Why does he come here? Why don't you tell him to stay away?
Roy, Mr. Sutton's a good man. Since your father died, we've been only half a family. Now we're going to live like other folks. There'll be a man in the house.
Ma, I'm a man.
I know, but you're still my baby. Honey, I want to tell you about Mr. Sutton and me.
I know about Mr. Sutton. You got no right coming in here. Why, you don't need him. You got me. I promised Pa I'd take care of you, and I will. Anything you want.
Well, it's more than that, son. God willing, I've got a time to live yet, and I don't want to do it alone. I want a man I can respect, like Mr. Sutton.
He's no good, don't you see that? All he's after is this house. And everything why he even walked out that door wearing Pa's jacket. He'll take everything he can get, Mom.
Roy, you stop that kind of talk. Now, I said we'd be a family, a whole family. You're going to have a father again.
My father's dead. And we don't want that Sutton around here. Not where Pa was. Not in his place. Pa, don't let him come back no more. Tell him I'm going to do things for you.
Son, you've always been a good boy. Now you'll understand about Mr. Sutton. We'll get along like we always do.
Ma, why can't you see that he's fooling you?
Nobody's fooling me. Mr. Sutton's got his own farm, makes a good living. All he wants is us.
Ma, you're not going to marry him.
Now, Roy, you listen to me.
You don't want him. You don't need him. And I'll prove it to you. I'll get money for you, all you want, enough for everything. And you watch. You don't need any man here but me.
Roy!
Seven more. Seven men beaten. Seven men robbed.
I got it. That's what counts. All we need. And I get more. All you want.
Did you borrow it? Who did you borrow it from, Roy?
Well, you don't have to worry. I told you I can take care of you like Pa. I can do things. This house is nothing. I said you'd have better someday, and you will. And clothes, too, Ma. Fancy clothes.
Roy, I don't know what you've done. Take this back. Wherever you got it, take it back. Quick.
Well, Ma, it's for you. I'm helping you. You don't have to marry Mr. Sutton now. You can tell him to stay away from you.
Roy, I don't want the money.
Not enough. You think it's too small? Well, tell me, Ma, I can get more, much more, all we need.
What have you done?
Dad said he was coming back. I'll show him. I'll show him you don't need him.
Hello, Roy. Had yourself quite a day, I hear. Where's the gun, Roy?
I can't go with you. I gotta keep my Ma away from Mr. Sutton. I just can't go.
Roy!
Ma! Let me stay here! Let me stay! I gotta take care of my Ma!
Take him to the car.
Hey, Ma, I wanna stay!
Right.
I wanna stay!
Sheriff, you don't understand. He thought I needed money. He was trying to help me. He wouldn't hurt anybody.
This gun is loaded, Mrs. Brown. I'm sorry.
A sudden outburst of crime and arrest had come over the state newswire. But to Tony Slaughter of the Star-Telegram, something had been left out. It was enough time to his next edition to find it.
Hello, Roy.
You the lawyer? My Ma sent you?
No, I'm a reporter, kid.
Well, I got nothing to say.
Why did you do it, Roy? Seven holdups in one afternoon, that's taking an awful lot of chances. Two of your victims caught the license plate on your car. Why? Now look, kid, maybe you had a good reason for what you're doing, but give it to me straight and I'll print it. It might help you in court. First offender, they might give you a break.
You mean, they beg it off?
Well, I didn't say that, Roy, but a lot of things can happen in a courtroom.
Yeah, but you could find out, right? A reporter, you know the sheriff. He promised to help me. Really help me so they let me out of here.
Now, look, take it easy, son.
I just said I'd give you a break in my story. I didn't say I'd give you a key to get out of here.
Okay. Okay, forget it. I don't need you.
There's one thing you gotta learn. A man dies, and it's hard, and you miss him. But there isn't a thing in the world you can do about it. Now, your mother's gotta go on. She's got a life of her own to make. There's nothing wrong with that. Your father would want it that way.
No, he wouldn't. And I'm taking his place. Everything's gonna be just like it was. And you're not gonna be with Ma. You're not even gonna go near her.
Roy. You think you're helping your mother, but you're just ruining her life, and you're ruining your life, too. Now, let me get your lawyer and try to help you and try to get you back home.
Yeah, you mean fix it so I'll never get home again? That's just what you want, isn't it?
I'm sorry, Roy. Maybe someday you'll realize I mean no harm. I'm just trying to help you.
To contain the relentless fury within Roy Parker. The boy himself couldn't, the walls of a prison couldn't. Somehow, it got him through, made him free. Free to prove his idea of what makes a man.
It's from Roy.
Is it his handwriting? Oh, he's gone wild, crazy wild. Mary, I went to him and I said, I want to be your friend, I want to help you. I tried, Mary.
I'm not blaming you, Howard.
Well, then don't blame yourself. It's not your fault.
Never got over losing his father. The way they were together. Sometimes I was even jealous. Oh, he loved him. The day Frank died, he ran out of the house. Just running and running till he couldn't stop. The police had to find him lying in a field, crying till there was nothing left to him. I should have remembered that.
Mary.
It wasn't natural for him to accept you. I told it to him too sudden.
Mary, I've been coming by for months. He's known about us.
No, I didn't get him ready to accept it.
No, Mary, you didn't do anything wrong.
Didn't I?
I've got to make you understand. Hello, Mr. Sutton. Have they found him yet?
No, not yet.
Mary, this is Tony Slaughter from the newspaper.
Hello.
Have they any idea where he is?
Just that he's as far away as he can get. What he's done will look pretty bad in the newspaper, Mrs. Parker. Now, Mr. Sutton told me a little bit about Roy, but maybe if you tell me something about him, I'm pretty sure I could use it.
There's nothing to tell.
Mary, he's just trying to help us.
I'll take care of things like I did before you came.
Well, you want him running loose, a fugitive?
I want you to let me alone.
Well, look, this isn't going to settle anything. The longer he's free, the worse things can get. Now, if you really want to help...
Howard?
You'll have to see that he's caught soon, and the sooner the better, before he does something serious. Have you heard from him, Mrs. Parker?
No.
Mary.
I don't know where he is.
Mr. Slaughter.
Howard, don't!
It's the only thing to do.
Roy said you were against him. You want him to be caught.
Now, look, I'm doing the best thing for you and for him. Mr. Slaughter, he's still in Fort Worth. He mailed us last night. You can check the postmark.
You are trying to break up Roy and me. You want him to be caught.
Stop, Mary.
Roy was right.
Now, Mary, stop it. Now, listen to me. You don't mean all these things you've been saying. You're just trying to defend Roy, and you know you can't. Now, look, I'm acting for you until you can see things straight.
Mr. Slaughter, we want you to turn that over to the police. We want to pound.
If he's smart, he'll stay in the wooded area around Boyd. We'll flush him out from all four sides of this area. Each man will get his own assignment. The Fort Worth and county cars will tie into the state radio network. Any change in instructions will come from there.
The manhunt was on. In the eyes of the law, a desperate criminal was loose. Fort Worth City Police, Texas Rangers, Sheriff's Department, and a Cowtown posse all would search with but one idea in mind. 100 like Roy Parker wasn't worth one peace officer dead.
One way to explain it, Mrs. Parker. Roy is sick.
He's trying to help me.
Other boys help, but not his way. He's lost reason, Mrs. Parker.
He loves me.
Mary, you can't help him this way. Now, you've got to face the truth.
Mr. Sutton's right. Police are calling him a wild animal. He's liable to kill one of them. They won't take any chances, Mrs. Parker.
No.
But they know what he's been doing. What would it look like to you, Mary, if he weren't your son?
He's a boy, not a criminal.
Yes, but he's a boy who's in trouble with himself. Now, you've got to admit that fact. Now, maybe you can help save him. Maybe you can get him back here. Give him a chance to get well.
I could explain to them what he's been doing, that he didn't mean to do wrong.
Mary, it's gone way beyond that now. Mr. Slaughter told you the boy's sick.
He said you'd do whatever I ask. I know how we can help Roy.
How?
Write him a letter. I know you haven't any address, but we'll print this letter in my paper. Your handwriting exactly as you write it. And then I'll do my best to get the paper to him.
But you want me to send him to the police?
Mary, please.
You know what they'll do to him? They'll put him away. You know what that'll do to him.
I know what they'll do when they find him.
Write the letter, Mary. He needs you. Tell him to come home.
Never a newspaper delivery like this one. None that anyone could remember. But what other way was there? None that anyone could see.
Well, it's been a long time.
There's a lot of land out there.
I put down over 200 papers.
It'll be a miracle if he finds one of them. I think I'll look around outside.
How many times have I waited for my boy to come home? He'd come down the road after school and I'd have his milk ready. Growing up, getting stronger. happened to him? What happened in those days? Why did it all turn out so bad?
I read what you said, Ma, that you wanted me back. I told you, didn't I? Someday you'd see. It was me you needed, just me.
You did the right thing, Roy. Your mother just about saved your life.
Why is he here?
Roy, what I said in that letter.
I know every word you wrote, Ma. It's me you want, nobody else.
Oh, I didn't say that, Roy.
Now, there's no sign of him. Oh, hello, son.
What did you do?
Roy.
The trick. Hey, you thought they'd make me give up.
No, no, we're going to make everything all right.
Your mother and me, we didn't see what was happening to you. We didn't know that it got worse the more you kept thinking about it. Now, we're going to make it up to you. We're going to get the best help there is.
You lying old man.
Roy!
Don't you worry, Ma. I'll take care of it. Straighten things out, just like he said.
Roy, you're sick.
There's nothing wrong with me. You're the one who made everything bad. But I'm gonna fix you.
Roy, I'm very sorry for you.
For me? You're gonna get what you wanted.
Roy, put that gun down.
I'm doing this for you, Ma.
You are sick. You always wanted to be like your father. Do you think he'd go out like you are, robbing and beating? Stealing like some cheap little bum? Holding a gun like a maniac?
What are you saying, Ma?
You said it was Mr. Sutton you didn't like. You're a liar. You don't want me to ever get married. You'd hate whoever came into this house. Because you're a boy. A little boy who needs a mama to hold his hand.
I'm a man.
You're a kid. A stupid, no good kid. Mr. Sutton didn't come to me. I went to him. I wanted him. I wanted him to take care of me. I needed him. I needed a man in my house.
Why, you don't know what you're saying. You don't.
Your father died. This house turned empty. I didn't want to live alone. Never come anywhere near your father. Never. I'm ashamed of you, same as he would be. I don't care what happens to you. I don't need you. I don't want you.
Ma.
Don't touch me. I wish you were dead.
Take me out of here. Take me out of here.
Just 60 seconds, you'll have a rendezvous with the real Tony Slaughter to learn how his big story ended. And now to the city room of the Fort Worth Star-Telegram as Tony Slaughter tells you how the court ruled in tonight's story.
Because of the car and the driver Roy Parker had used in his escape, he was indicted for kidnapping, in addition to all the charges of armed robbery. He was given 4 30-year sentences, all sentences to run concurrently.
Roy Parker learned too late that a man who seeks power through destruction becomes his own victim. Till next week, then, at the Big Story newsstand, good night.